it's been said that every kid has a bug period, you know, you 9 or 10, you bring home spiders and all sorts of creepy crawlies and jars and so on. And I had a bug period, but I never grew out of it. And was just delighted to find as I got older that there are careers in science working on bugs, and one thing led to another. I've been at Harvard for 51 years. I came as a graduate student. And during that period of time, I've worked on a wide variety of subjects. Many of them pivoted on the study of ants. First of all, from ants, we've learned an awful lot about basic biology. For example, how they communicate almost exclusively with chemicals. This is such a different world. It's almost what the kind of a world you would imagine on another planet. Highly social creatures communicating not by words, sounds, not by vision, but by letting out different odors to communicate messages. They've taught us that. We've learned a lot about the origin of altruism and cooperation in evolution. That's one level. The second level would be, what can they teach us about the proper conduct of our own societies? And the answer has got to be nada, zilch, nothing. We don't want to live like ants. But first of all, they're the most warlike of all animals. Their colonies are always fighting. And second, of course, as everyone knows, they're highly subordinated to the communal activity. There are no three freedoms, there are no Bill of Rights, there's nothing, because they're programmed, you know, to act so closely together. And I like to say, just to tweak my Marxist friends, that Karl Marx was right. He just had the wrong species. My most recent work and a great deal of my time and energies have gone in to the exploration of the world's biological diversity, which we now understand is mostly unknown, particularly in small creatures like insects and bacteria. I would say more than 90% of the species haven't even been discovered. But we're also learning and beginning to put a measure on a very fast and accelerating rate of extinction of those species. We're wiping out a large part of biodiversity. I'm on the board of directors or advisory boards of most of the large conservation organizations, the ones that deal with the global environment. So I've been very much involved in laying plans to save as much of the world's ecosystems as possible. And most particularly in the developing countries that have tropical forest, coral reefs, and other biologically rich environments. And I'm optimistic that before too long, we can develop worldwide strategies that will save a large part of the world's remaining biological diversity.